Hello, this is Matthew Robert Payne. This is a little teaching called It May Not Be False. There's many people out there that write blogs and do YouTube videos and accuse people of being false prophets and false teachers. They accuse certain movements of being unscriptural and have all their scripture references and do much research and say that this is a false movement and this is not of God, and these people of the latter rain are deceived and they believe in these things which are extra biblical and they're wrong and this is false teaching. This little video is to say it may not be false. You remember the Christian faith started as what they call a sect. It's the old term for what is called a cult. The Christian church was a cult that branched off the Jewish faith. At one time, there were people, religious leaders, well-trained religious leaders, saying that Christianity was false. But we all know that it proved to be the truth. So too, in this day, when certain people call something a false teaching, certain people call a movement a false movement, when certain people say that a revival isn't a true revival, as satanic, and it's not of God, so too that can be the case. So too there can be elements of truth running through what people call false. You know, I made this very interesting enlightenment. I got this very interesting insight recently, and that was that the only people that experience false manifestations of the Holy Spirit are the Pentecostals and the Charismatic. Because the Baptist and the mainline churches that aren't filled with the Holy Spirit, they've got no manifestations of the true Holy Spirit. And so why would there need to be false? Satan only comes in to deceive and trick genuine Christians when there's something to have a false manifestation about. If there's no true manifestation of the Holy Spirit, someone's head shaking, there can be no false. There is no reason for a false. If people aren't being knocked over or under the power of the Holy Spirit and being slain by the Holy Spirit with a true manifestation of the Holy Spirit, well then there's no need to be having false manifestations. So too with false teaching. So many people call what is false just a new insight, a new revelation of the Holy Scriptures. When someone comes up with a revelation that's new, it isn't necessarily false. Jesus told a parable about how people sowed seed on the wayside and the birds came and snatched it up straight away. And this is when the Word of God is preached in such a way with revelation that people, because they've got preconceived ideas, the Word comes in and they allow Satan to snatch that Word away. They allow Satan. And what they do is they're saying, this is false, I don't agree with this, this doesn't agree with my teaching. If I was to say that you're not once saved, always saved, that someone who's a Christian isn't guaranteed to go to heaven, there's certain sins, unrepentant sins that a Christian can have in their life that'll stop them from going to heaven, many people will say that's false. Now, that isn't false according to scripture, but many people will say it is. So too they call false teaching false when there's a revelation that may be right and it's just disagreeing with what they already know. We've all got preconceived ideas, we've all got ways we want the Holy Spirit to behave in, we've all got notions and ways that we believe the Word of God should speak and doctrines and all sorts of things that make us in this little set where we're going a certain way and believing a certain thing. And when something out of the ordinary comes, sometimes people just have too much of a hard time accepting the new wave, the new revelation of... Now, a new revelation doesn't have to be wrong. It can just be a higher revelation. There's so many levels to scripture. If someone thinks that a scripture can only be interpreted one way and not in a higher way, well, that's just like saying, Jesus saying, I'm the bread of life. And if Jesus was bread, you should be able to sit down and cut him up and spread butter on him. But he was saying that he's the life, and his body is going to be sacrificed as bread is eaten in the Last Supper. We knew it was symbolism. But Jesus said, unless you eat of my body and drink of my blood, you have no part of me. And everyone left him. They thought he was asking people to drink his blood, and that was a Jewish no-no. You're not allowed to drink flesh with blood in it, and that part of the Jewish law. And so it was like Jesus was asking them to disobey the law. Now, we know in hindsight, Jesus was talking about a symbol of his own body being crucified on the cross. So we know Jesus wasn't saying that, but historically people walked away. The same is true today with a new revelation. The people who hear the revelation, who aren't moving in the Spirit, may think that the revelation is off and it's a false teaching, and this is simply might not be the case. So I want you to be rest assured that many of the things that people are moving in, many of the revelations that are coming to earth these days, and many of what people call false teaching may not be false teachings. And there may be nuggets of truth in even the most despised of cults. So you need to have your eyes open. One thing you need to do is to know the Word of God for yourself, not from the pulpit, but by reading it yourself. And by the Word of God, you can discern what is the truth and what isn't. And you need to know Jesus. You need to know the Holy Spirit and have them speak to you. All you have to do is ask Jesus whether this is the truth or not, and he can answer you. If you know Jesus personally, this can save you a lot of trouble. So, let me just finish with, it may not be false.